All right, it's time to get ready for our unit 4 test. And so the first one, this is our parent function right here. There's been no transformations, just y equals the square root of x. And so if you needed to, you can always go into your calculator, y equals square root of x, and just see what it looks like. There's what it looks like. You can always go into your table and get some points and plot these points. But as a reminder, we always started at 0, 0. That's just from plugging in points. Square root of 0 is 0. Square root of 1 is 1. We don't know 2. We don't know 3. But the square root of 4 is 2. So those are our points that we always use. 1, 1, 2, and 4, 2. And so my starting point right here was 0, 0, and it goes all the way to the right. So my domain starts at 0 and goes to infinity. And then my range starts at 0 and goes to infinity. The furthest left point is 0, and the furthest bottom point is also 0. Sorry, there's something on my paper. All right, so then we'll continue number 2. Draw the graph of square root of x minus 4 minus 1. So we're going to list all transformations. X minus 4 is going to go to the right 4, and then down 1. And so my starting point is going to be 4, negative 1. There's no stretch, there's no compress, so everything's going to be normal, just like these points over here. So when I go right 1, I'm going to go up 1, and right 4 will go up 2. And so there's our square root graph that's been shifted right 4 and down 1. My domain on this one starts at positive 4 and goes all the way to the right to infinity. My range starts at negative 1 and goes all the way up to infinity. And then it asks, what are the x and y intercepts? And so the x intercept where it crosses the x axis is right there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. My y intercept, it never touches the y axis, and so that's none. And then we'll more list all transformations. So this negative is going to reflect it over the x-axis. So instead of going up, it's going down. The 2 is going to be that vertical stretch by a factor of 2. We're going to the left 5. And we're going up 3. And so this tells me my starting point. So my starting point is going to be negative 5. 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. There's my starting point. And then on this one, we are reflecting it. So instead of going up, we're going down, and we're stretching it by 2. So if you wanted to, you could always, again, put it in your calculator. And so I've got negative 2 square root of x plus 5, and then on the outside, plus 3. So that's what the graph should look like. You can go into your table and get some points. So we said our starting point should be negative 5, 3. There's our starting point, negative 5, 3. I can go to my next point, negative 4, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1. And so I can gather some points right off the table. Or you can do what we've been doing. When I go right 1, I usually go up 1. Right 4, I usually go up 2. But now we're multiplying by negative 2. And so now we're going to go down 2. And we're going to go down 4. And so right 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, down 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And so there's my transform square root graph. And so my domain furthest left is right here at negative 5, all the way to the right to infinity. My range, the lowest point is negative infinity, and it's going all the way up to 3. As far as the x and y intercepts go, the x intercept is somewhere in there. I can't see exactly where it is, so I'm going to use the calculator, or I could solve either way. My y intercept, again, I can't really see. And so here's one nice thing in the calculator. I'll go back to the calculator in my table. I'll go to where x is 0, and there's my y value. So my y-intercept is going to be negative 1.472. My x-intercept, I'm going to come down here and I'm going to solve it. And so I'm going to put 0 equals negative 2 square root of x plus 5 plus 3, and we'll solve for the x. And so I'll subtract 3 over. I'll divide by negative 2, so that becomes 3 over 2. I'll square both sides. And so when I square this fraction, it's going to square both the numerator and the denominator, so that becomes 9 over 4 equals x plus 5. And so x equals 9 over 4 minus 5. And so I'll just go ahead and put that in the calculator. And so 9 over 4 minus 5, negative 2.75. One, two, and it looks to be about right. All right, moving on to the next page. Find the inverse of the following. As a reminder, you can either switch location and operation, or actually switch your x and your y and solve for y. So I'll go ahead and show all the work. X equals square root of y minus 4 plus 3. We're going to subtract the 3 over. We'll square both sides. And then we'll add the 4 over. So y equals x minus 3 squared, and then plus 4. Again, I'll switch the x and y. So x equals y minus 1 squared plus 7. We'll subtract the 7 over. Now we're going from squared to square root. And so as a reminder, when I go to square root, I'm always going to put that plus or minus in front. That gives me both sides of that sideways parabola, the positive and the negative. And so I've got x minus 7 equals y minus 1. Then last of all, add that 1 over. So plus or minus square root, x minus 7, and then plus 1 on the outside. And so again, I'll have x equals negative 2 square root of y plus 6 minus 2. I'll add the 2 over. I'll divide by negative 2. The opposite of square root is we're going to square both sides. So I'll come up here, x plus 2 over negative 2 squared equals y plus 6. And then last I will subtract 6 over. And so x plus 2 divided by negative 2 squared minus 6. All right, we're going to do another graph, and so that's going to go left 3 and up 2, and so my starting point is going to be negative 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. And this one is reflected over, so we're going to go over 1, down 1, right 4, and down 2. So my domain starts at negative 3 and goes to infinity. My range starts at negative infinity, the lowest point, all the way to the highest point of 2. My x-intercept we can see on this one is 1. Y-intercept I know is between 0 and 1. The easiest way to do it is go to the calculator. And so I'll go to my calculator and we'll do y equals negative square root of x plus 3. And then on the outside, plus 2. So my graph looks good. When x is 0, y is 0.2679. All right, so after all the errors, this is going to be my starting point. And so we're going left 2 and down 7. So x plus 2 is going to go left 2, and down 7 is minus 7. And then I'm just going to see, are there any stretches, compresses, anything else? And so when it goes right 1, right here from negative 7 to negative 6, it's going plus 1. No stretch, no compress. That's it. Again, this is my starting point. So we're going left 5 and up 1. So x plus 5 is going to go left 5. And plus 1 is going to go up 1. And then from 1 to negative 1, when it went right 1, now we're going down 2. That's my flip and my stretch. And so negative 2 is going to go in front, and that's it. All right, now we're getting into solving. So the first thing we want to do is isolate the radical. So I'm going to add the 6 over to get 7x plus 1 under the radical equals positive 6. So I added that 6 over. And so now that the radical is by itself, we're going to square both sides. We'll subtract the 1 over and then divide by 7. And then we're just going to check and make sure that it works. And so just like we've been doing in class, I'm going to store 5 into my x, and then we'll just check it from that original. Negative 6 plus square root of 7x plus 1 equals 0, and checks. Radical is by itself, so we're going to square both sides. 9 equals 1 minus 2x. We'll subtract the 1 over to get 8 equals negative 2x. And we'll divide by negative 2 to get x equals negative 4. So negative 4, store into my x. And then square root of 1 minus 2x. It does equal 3. Check. Radicals on both sides, we'll square both sides, which gets rid of both radicals. X plus 6 equals negative 1 minus 6x. I'll add the 6x over here to get 7x. And at the same time, I'm going to subtract the 6 over to get negative 7. So to show what I did, I added 6x over here, and I subtracted 6 over here. So it got rid of those, it got rid of those, and now I divide by 7 to get x equals negative 1. Then again, we'll go into our calculator, negative 1, store x. On the left side, I've got square root of x plus 6. On the right side, I've got square root of negative 1 minus 6x. They're both the same thing, so it checks. Radicals on both sides, I can't divide by 3, so we're going to square both sides. But when I square this side, it's going to go to both the 3 and the radical. And so I've got 7 minus 2x equals 3 squared, which is 9, negative 2 minus 3x. And I will distribute that 9. To get negative 18 minus 27x, and then we'll solve for x. I'm going to add the 27x over here, and we're going to subtract the 7 over here. So that's going to be 25x equals negative 25, so x equals negative 1 from dividing by 25. So my x is already negative 1. I don't have to change it, and so we'll just check it. 7 minus 2x under the radical is equal to 3. And 3 square root of negative 2 minus 3x is also 3, and so that checks. Going on to the last page, some more solving. This one has x under the radical and outside, so we want to get the radical by itself. We'll add the x over. We're going to square both sides. And so x minus 7 squared means we're going to come out to the side, x minus 7 times x minus 7, which is x squared minus 7x plus 49. I'll combine these to get x squared minus 14x plus 49 is equal to 42 minus 6x. Anytime I have x squared, I need to move everything to one side. And so I'm going to subtract the 42 and add the 6x. So adding the 6x over is going to get a negative 8x. Subtracting the 42 over is going to get a positive 7. And then I want to try and think what multiplies a 7 and adds a negative 8. That's going to be a negative 7 and a negative 1. And so x minus 7, x minus 1 equals 0. And so x equals 7 and x equals 1. And then we'll just check it. So I'll just check with the original. I'll start with the 7, so I'll put 7 store x, and it should equal negative 7 when I'm done. So square root of 42 minus 6x minus x, negative 7. So the 7 checks. And then for the 1, I'll do 1 store x. And I don't have to type in the whole thing. I'll just copy and paste that down. Check it, it doesn't equal negative 7, so the 1 does not check, so x equals 7. Again, on this one, we're going to want to isolate the radical, so I'm going to add the x over. and come out to the side, and we're gonna square both sides. And so x minus 6 times x minus 6, we'll get x squared minus 6x minus 6x plus 36. We'll combine like terms to get x squared minus 12x plus 36 equals x minus 6. I have x squared, so we're going to move everything to the other side. So I'm going to subtract x to get negative 13x, and we'll add 6 to get 42. And we want to try and think, okay, what multiplies to 42 and adds to negative 13? So this one may be a little trickier, but you can play with your calculator if you want a little bit, but negative 6 and negative 7. 6 times 7 is 42. Negative and a negative make it a positive, and it works. And so I get x minus 6, x minus 7, and so x equals 6 and 7, and then we'll check them. And so I'll store 6 into x, and then we'll plug it in. I'll just do the original. So square root of x minus 6 minus x equals negative 6, check. And then we'll 7 store x. And then we'll do the same thing. I'll just come up here, copy and paste it down. Equals negative 6, that's another check. All right, and then this one's gonna be our hardest one. So I'll go ahead and square both sides. And so I'm gonna get 3x minus 8. Is equal to, and this is gonna be a little bit harder. And so when I do that, those cancel out, just be 5 minus x, and then I'm gonna have plus square root of 5 minus x, and then plus another square root of 5 minus x, and plus 1. I'll combine like terms, and so right here I've got two of those. I've got a negative x, I'll put that in the front. I've got plus 6, and I've got two of those, so plus 2 square root of 5 minus x. And now I want to get the radical by itself, and so I'm going to add the x over, which is going to get 4x. I'll subtract the 6 over to get negative 14. And then I'll go ahead and divide the 2 over as well, because these are both divisible by 2, so 2x minus 7 equals square root of 5 minus x, and now we'll square it again. So this has a lot of steps to it. So 2x minus 7 times 2x minus 7, that's gonna be 4x squared minus 14x minus 14x plus 49. And so we're gonna have 4x squared, that's become negative 28x plus 49 is equal to 5 minus x. And we're getting close, so we're gonna move everything to the other side. So we'll add the x over to get negative 27x. We'll subtract the 5 over to get 44. And so 4 times 44, it's gonna be 176, negative 27 on the bottom. And so this is a little bit trickier. And so I'm gonna play with the calculator a little bit, try and figure out what it could be. I know it's gotta be two negatives that are gonna add to 27 and multiply to that. And so it's gotta be numbers less than 27. And so I'll just start playing with some numbers and seeing what I get. So 22, and 8 doesn't work. Finally found it, 16 and 11. And so I was just in my calculator, just dividing it out, trying to figure out, okay, what's gonna work. And so divide by 4, and so I get 4x minus 11. And then over here, that's gonna become negative 4 over 1, x minus 4. And so x equals 11 over 4 and x equals 4. And then we'll just check those. And so I'm gonna have 11 over 4 store into my x. And so square root of 3x minus 8 on the left-hand side, square root of 5 minus x plus 1. They don't equal each other, and so that's not a correct solution. And then we'll store 4 into x and do the same thing. And so those two are equivalent, so 4 checks. So x equals 4 is my only answer. And then last one, Jill wants to build a rectangular pen for her dog. The number of feet of fencing can be determined using the formula where F represents the feet of fencing and A represents the area. If Jill has a 60 feet of fencing, what is the square feet of the pen for her dog? So we're gonna plug in what we know, 60 feet, and solve for what we don't know. So we'll subtract 15 over, and so it gets 45 equals. And then we'll square both sides. So 2025 equals A plus 225. And then we'll subtract the 225. And so A is equal to 1800. And A represents the area, which should be feet squared. All right, and that completes our review. Let me know if you have any questions.